Welcome to the Blazor Charts tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to create and customize the column chart in Syncfusion Blazor Charts component. Additionally, I'll demonstrate how to customize features such as data labels, axis labels, series, titles, and more to enhance the chart's clarity and readability. Let me show you the steps to create a column chart in the Syncfusion Blazor Chart control. Before that, let's delve into a real-time scenario and example data. In our case, I'll customize the column chart to visualize the top insurance companies in the USA based on their 2022 market capitalization. If you want to see the data for top insurance company in USA, check the link provided in the description below. Although there are over 50+ Syncfusion chart types available in Blazor, for this real-time example data, it is indeed wise to use a column chart. This type of chart effectively visualizes trends and fluctuations over time. Now let me open an existing Blazor web app in auto mode. If you want to know how to create a Blazor web app with auto mode selection, check out the video linked in the above YouTube card. Here, the Syncfusion Blazor Charts NuGet package has been installed in a client project to utilize the Blazor Charts component. Also, ensure that you register the Syncfusion Blazor service in both the server and client-side program CS file. If you want to learn how to add the Syncfusion Blazor Charts component to a Blazor web app, check out the video link provided in the description below. Now that everything is configured, let me proceed to add the Syncfusion Blazor charts. For that, I open the Home Razor component and replace the default code and define the Syncfusion Blazor chart component. Next, I'll show you how to add data to the Blazor chart and display it as a column series. To render a column series chart within the Home Razor component, I first need to define the chart series collection tag, which is an array that can contain any number of chart series definitions. Since I'm planning to add a single column series chart, I define a single chart series tag with the type property set to column to render the column series chart. Next, I'll prepare the data for the chart to provide the top insurance companies with market values. Therefore, I create the insurance company class. Within the class, I set the two properties named company name and market capitalization to hold the insurance company's data. To generate the collection of company names with market value, I create the insurance company's list of type insurance company MODA class. Within the list, I set the array of company name and market value based on top insurance companies in USA, determined by their 2022 market capitalization. Next, I bind the insurance company's list to the data source property. Additionally, map the data source fields company name to X name and market capitalization to Y name properties of the chart series. Here, I am going to use category value data in the X-axis. So I define a chart primary X-axis tag and set the value type property to category. Let's run the example application. You can see the column chart rendered with the provided data. Notice that the company names are on the x-axis and market capitalizations on the y-axis. Next, I will show you how to customize the chart's appearance by customizing the axis labels, showing data labels at the column points, adding data markers, and adding titles to the charts. In this demo, you may notice that the X-axis label American International overflows the allotted space. If you wish to customize the X-axis labels, you can do so by adding the label intersect action property and setting it to wrap. This action enables labels to wrap when they're too long for the space available, letting the text flow onto the next line within the container. Furthermore, if you don't want to display x-axis grid lines on a chart, you can achieve this by defining the chart axis major grid lines tag and setting the width property to 0. Look, now you can see that the particular label is wrapped, and also see the x-axis grid lines are removed. Next, I will show you how to add a title with an insurance icon. To achieve this, I'll place an image tag within a division tag and apply the styles to align the image. Then I'll add the title within another division tag and customize their width and font size using CSS attributes. Additionally, I'll set the x-axis title as insurance companies. Look, now you can see that the column chart is rendered with the provided title along with the image. Also, notice that the x-axis title is insurance companies. Next, I will guide you through customizing the data labels. To add the data label, I'll define the chart data label tag inside the chart marker tag and set the visible property to true. To adjust the position of the data label, I'll set the position property. There are 5 available positions: outer, auto, middle, top, and bottom. In this case, I'll set the position to middle. Furthermore, I'll add the data label format to display dollar values with a billion symbol. Look, now you can see the data labels are rendered in the middle position and with the specified format. Next, I will show you how to customize the column series. To change the color of the column series, I'll set the fill property to custom color. To customize the border of the column series, I define the chart series border tag and set the width and color properties with appropriate values. To highlight the series, I set the dash array property to 5,5. Look, now you can see the column series rendered with the provided color and border customization. Next, I will demonstrate how to adjust the column space and width. In this demo, you'll notice some spacing between the two columns. This spacing is based on series. If you wish to customize the column spacing, simply set the column spacing property to 0.3. Look, now you can see the column series rendered with the provided column spacing. If you want to customize the width of the column series, set the column width property to 1. The default value of the column width is based on series. Look, now observe the updated column width. Next, I will show you how to enable and customize the rounded column. I define the chart corner radius tag and set the properties for each corner to 35. Look, now you can see the resulting rounded columns. Next, I'll demonstrate how to enable and customize the tooltip. To enable the tooltip, I've defined the tooltip settings tag and set the enable property to true. To customize the tooltip format, I've set the header property to insurance company and modified the format property accordingly. See here, notice that when hovering over the column series, the tooltip is rendered with the provided format. Now let me summarize. I showed you how to add the Syncfusion Blazor chart component in a Blazor web app. I also covered how to enable and customize some features of the column chart with real-time examples. If you want to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.